Thank you very much, sir. And now, ladies and gentlemen, our esteemed guest, Sri Kamal Nath, will say a few words. Please join me in welcoming him on stage.
Good evening to all of you, and I take this opportunity to congratulate the entire Lanco family, a family which has demonstrated distinction and made India proud. It's almost 20 years, almost to the month, since India embarked on its reforms program. And for 20 years, India has unleashed its intellectual and entrepreneurial abilities. And a demonstration of that couldn't be better in seeing the success story of Lanco. 20 years ago, who would have thought that there would be a Lanco? Even 15 years ago, who would have thought that a construction company, a mid-sized construction company, would be speaking of being the largest private sector power producer in the country? And this exemplifies entrepreneurship, it exemplifies India's talent, and it exemplifies the leadership which is able to harmonize all this and create the synergy which creates an organization which leads not only in India, but as I was hearing the chairman say, going across India into other countries, largest port in Australia, natural resources in Africa. And most of all, the Lanco story is about inclusiveness. And that is really the challenge in India. As we grow, the challenge is not merely sustaining growth, but the challenge is in managing growth. And in managing growth, the biggest challenge is the challenge of all-inclusive growth. Governments cannot do this alone. It is the private sector which has to do this and join hands with government in ensuring that our growth touches all sections of society and all parts of the country. And in this, again, Lanco has exemplified its efforts in this direction. So 25 years is a moment of pride. It's not a very, very long age for a company, but 25 years is an important milestone, which sets the tone for the next 25 years. And the chairman has spelt his vision, and I want to congratulate the entire Lanco team that the next 25 years, you'll not only keep the Lanco flag flying, but the Indian flag flying. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir, for those words of encouragement, and thank you for your presence. May I now request our esteemed guest, Mr. Muniyappa, Minister of State for Railways, to kindly do the honors of ushering in the new era for Lanco with his auspicious hands. Lanco is ready to set out into a new era with a brand new identity and the inspiration behind the 25-year journey to the present, which will show the way to the future.
Tribute to the past, the spirit of enterprise, the inspiration. A leap from an everyday occurrence to create something unusual. The inspiration, Lagarapati Amrappa Naidu and his entrepreneurial dream. For others, it was just a bus. But for Lagarapati Amarappa Naidu and his two brothers, Venkatarama Naidu and Venkataratanam Naidu, it symbolized an opportunity. One that led to the formation of a full-fledged transport business entity. Lagarapati Amarappa Naidu's visionary approach, intuitive business sense, and spirit of entrepreneurship laid the foundations of a robust organization. He remains a source of infinite inspirations. Where others saw weakness, he saw strength. The non-violent movement started by Mahatma Gandhi proved to the world that social transformation was possible when people unite to work for change.
Indefinable, mysterious power that pervades everything.
Be the change you want to see in the world, was his message to the world. Lagarapati Rajagopal, the founder chairman of the Lanco Group, was just 21 when he joined the group in 1985. He embarked on a journey in construction business along with his brother-in-law, G. Bhaskara Rao. With liberalization of the Indian economy in the 90s, L. Rajagopal saw an opportunity and invited Madhusudana Rao, his younger brother, to join him in an integrated industrial complex that could produce pig iron, ductile iron pipes, and cement. Was born. Where others saw impossibility, he saw possibility. Where others saw challenges, Lanco saw opportunity. In 1995, Lanco took up the state government's invitation to set up private power generation plants . In 2000, Lanco commissioned its very first 368 megawatt gas power plant in Kondapalli near Vijayawada, the largest in South India. In the same year, Lanco Construction became Lanco Infratech Limited. In 2002, Lagarapati Rajagopal retired from business to pursue an active role in politics, and Lagarapati Madhusudan Rao took over as the chairman. In 2006, he consolidated all its existing operations under Lanco Infratech Limited. Where others saw mass, he saw energy. Einstein proved that a small amount of matter had the potential to create a colossal amount of energy. Where others see shortages, Lanco sees abundance. Lanco's sand to power strategy is one of its many proactive initiatives in developing sustainable energy resources. It is the first Indian organization to integrate the entire solar value chain in the country. To leverage its core business in power, Manco has set up India's first manufacturing unit for the production of solar products. With acquisition of coal mines in Australia, it is determined to become the largest energy producer in India. When the world saw 11 players from diverse backgrounds, MS Dhoni saw a World Cup winning team. His exemplary leadership inspired every player to give in their career best performances. The spirit of togetherness led to a legendary achievement. Where others see people, we see power. It is people who create successful organizations, and Manco leverages its leadership, entrepreneurship and ownership framework to nurture talent and create high-performance growth leaders. Where others saw confusion, he saw the Indian Constitution. B.R. Ambedkar took up the challenge to fulfill the arduous task of formulating laws to govern the world's largest democracy. Where others see family tradition, we see innovation and professionalism. In 2009, a family constitution was framed. While it provides equal opportunities, only the most competent take the leadership position. Vision that ensures sustainable growth. Where others saw despair, she saw hope. Where others see deprivation, we see emancipation. The Manco Foundation, set up in 2000, helps underprivileged sections of society. Besides these initiatives, it supports and promotes rural craftsmen, from a regional to an international identity. It is inspiration that keeps us going. Today, we are more inspired than ever to enter a new era. Reach for the skies. Become the most admired integrated enterprise. We are ready to turn this dream into a reality.